the friends, he is Aman, he is my assistant, and he will be showing you all the movements around the shoulder joint and some special twist in relation to shoulder. First of all, some movements around the shoulder. What are the movements that we can do? Number one is abduction and adduction. Abduction is something like this, moving away from the body. This is abduction. Adduction would be moving towards the body or crossing the body like this. This is adduction. So abduction and adduction like this. Second movement around the shoulder would be rotational movement, internal rotation and external. When we say rotation or any movement at the shoulder, we must be focused over here, not at the elbow or the forearm, right? So this is normal position. When I move the forearm towards the body, this creates an internal rotation over the shoulder. When I move the forearm like this, this is creating an external rotation at the shoulder. Now this is external rotation and internal rotation. When he keeps his hand like this over his lower back, what he has done, this is the terminal internal rotation of the shoulder, right? Terminal internal rotation. What we do in this terminal internal rotation? This is the movement in which we check the action of subscapularis muscle, right? We ask the patient to keep his hand over the lower back. We ask him to push it, right? We just ask him to keep or move his hand away from the body like this, lift it off. Okay, you just keep little resistance over here. This is lift off test, which is done for subscapularis muscle. That is a question for your PGME examination. Okay, so internal rotation, terminal internal rotation and external rotation. Third movement is flexion and extension. See, this is shoulder. Flexion would be like this. So don't focus over the forearm or the elbow or the this arm area. Focus over the shoulder. So this is your flexion of the shoulder like this. And this is your extension of the shoulder going back. So extension and flexion. So three movements: flexion, extension, abduction, adduction, and rotational movements. These are three. When we talk about special test, one test I've already told you, the lift off test, which is for subscap. Second is about dislocation of the shoulder. Most commonly seen dislocation in the shoulder is the anterior dislocation, right? In anterior dislocation, this would be abducted and externally rotated, something like this. There is a gap, abduction and external rotation. Okay, so two special tests which we are asked in our examination also, and which can be asked as MCQ also. See, number one is Dugas, D-U-G-A. What we do in Dugas, we ask the patient to touch the opposite shoulder like this. Aman can do this because his both the shoulders are normal. Okay, if this shoulder is dislocated and the attitude is abduction and external rotation, he won't be able to touch his opposite shoulder. That is Dugas. Second is Hamilton ruler test. What is that? You have to take a scale, a big scale. There is a contour of the shoulder which is normal finding. Now what happens is, if I keep a scale over his normal shoulder, either the scale will touch the shoulder area or the elbow area, right? I cannot touch both the sides or both the points at one time. Whenever there is a dislocation and I keep a scale over here, starting from here till here, in case of dislocation, this scale will touch the tip of acromion as well as the lateral condyle at the same time. That is Hamilton ruler test, right? So Hamilton ruler tells you about the dislocation, the anterior dislocation of the shoulder joint. Two special tests, right? Third one is Caves, C-A-L-L-W-A-Y, in which we see the vertical fold, this, of the axilla here. Okay, so lift off test, Dugas test and Hamilton ruler test. These are three tests which are done for anterior dislocation of the shoulder, right?